you'll be sharing today with some of the best people around, handpicked by the happy couple. We also want to share this day with loved ones who are no longer with us in person, but always with us in spirit. In particular, the father of the bride, Len Morin, who is honored here today by a rose in his chair beside Carolyn.
Inside the broken halls of your heart, I do believe you gave.
Jennifer, since the moment I've met you, I've been inspired to look past myself and what I've always accepted as good enough. You've changed my entire perspective and helped me realize what's most important in life. Today, I ask that we join our lives into one and that we make this journey of growth and learning together.
Jennifer and Adam have asked for this reading. Please take heart. How falling in love is like owning a dog. On cold winter nights, love is warm. It lies between you and lives and breathes and makes funny noises. Love can wake you up at all hours of the night with its needs. Love can give you a sense of security. When you're walking down the street late at night and you have a leash on love, no one's going to mess with you. Love needs to be fed so it will grow and stay healthy. Love does not like being left alone. But come home and love is always happy to see you. Love may break a few things accidentally in its passion for life, but you can never be mad at love for long. Love leaves little surprises here and there. Most importantly, love needs love, and lots of it. And in return, love loves you and never stops.
They keep asking me if I'm nervous. Yeah. And I just keep telling them I shouldn't have to be. I'm getting the good deal here.
Smile on your face.
My sweet Adam, my heart is so full of happiness standing here with you today in front of our family and friends as we embark on our journey together as husband and wife. Over these past few years together, you've taught and continue to teach me so much about acceptance, patience, understanding, perseverance, and what it truly means to love wholeheartedly and unconditionally.
Oh, heavenly day.
It was called the blizzard of the year, the night our Adam chose to appear. We should have known on that blustery date that this January tempest was only a taste of our fate.
Gonna keep you out of town tonight.
A ride in a black Porsche at 11 convinced Adam that being in heaven was having a Porsche 911 in his possession, which to date had been his major obsession. One day, though, he called us announcing that his Porsche muse had taken a trouncing. Now possessing his mind and libido was a lass from Ottawa, over on the Rideau, a pretty singer and photographer named Jenn, who possessed a marketable acumen. She had an eye for approving Canada's meats, which never personally indulging, of course, in carnivorous treats.
Gonna make you carry me.
Where she lived, though, in old Ottawa, she wasn't liking the grade of the men that she saw. So she went online on Plenty of Fish in the Sea to see what her next dating prospects might be. Unsuccessful after weeks of window shopping, there was still nothing really eye-popping. All the suitors claimed to like long walks and books, but they traded mostly on shallow good looks. Until one clever posting had pics of four bros, all four of them. Said Jen, this is different. Maybe I'll try one of those. Like two birds playing tag on a wire, Jen jousted with Adam, the guy from Canadian Tire. To meet this guy in person was risky. It could burst the bubble. Though when on their first date she saw him, said Jen, uh-oh, I think I'm in trouble. No matter how, it seems the love bug had bitten, and with each other they seemed mightily smitten. So last Thanksgiving, they went to a park with Marley and Juno, their critters that bark. There Adam dropped to one knee to ask if Jen's soulmate she'd accept him to be. In that park, on a bridge, Jen said yes. Much to our great relief, we confess, because for years it's been our family's fervent mission to ensure that Adam has adequate adult supervision.
As some of us may know, Adam works at Canadian Tire. As some of you may have had dealings with Canadian Tire, and more of you may have had returns to do at Canadian Tire, you understand that there are return policies, there are care and maintenance warranties to have. So, first and foremost, I'd like to thank you on behalf of all the Rosenecks for shopping at Roseneck. Though you may not have shopped at our good, our better, or our best, you did shop in our as-is section.
I never had favorites with my kids either. Adam being the first was probably the most challenging of my four. For all he's challenged us, because Adam always challenges, he's always, and his vows were so relevant to both of us because they were so truthful in what he promises to you. When Adam makes a promise and makes a vow, he goes after it with a vengeance. He goes after, as he did you, with a determination and a dogged determination until he gets what he wants.
I promise to inspire you to be adventurous and dream bigger than you've ever dreamt. Because together, no dream will ever be out of our reach. I promise to always rub your feet at the end of a hard day. Because that's what you say a good husband does.
So when I first heard about Adam, I'm like, who is this guy? And you know, as a girlfriend reader kind of thing, I'm like, oh, I don't know. Well, this guy turned out to be a great guy, who is very intelligent, who also has a love for animals. How am
I forgiven? Adam, you make my sister truly happy. I can see it in her eyes. By the way, she talks about you, and I know that you are deeply in love with her. Please remember, though, that even though she's becoming a Roseneck today, the Morin silliness is in the DNA, and that will always stay with her. I'm very happy and honored to call you my brother-in-law and welcome you with open arms into our family.
Ooh, you make me live. Whatever this this world can give to me.
Jennifer, you look amazing today. You're so beautiful. Words cannot express the happiness and overwhelming love I feel for you today.
You make me live. Oh, you're the best friend.
There is one very important person that I want to talk about now, which is our dad. He would be beaming with pride today, Jennifer, when you become, and I know he's here. From the rainbows you've seen, to the sunshine on your face, to the wind blowing through your hair, and to all the stars that twinkled in the sky last night. He is all around, and he is very happy for you.
Ooh, you make me live. Oh, I've been wandering round. Still,
she has grown into a beautiful woman who is multi-talented and who has the most amazing singing voice. A voice that is a gift from her dad, and I know he is here in spirit and is smiling down on a special occasion today, the day of his birthday.
Whenever this world is cruel to me, I got you.
Adam, you are our big brother. I'm absolutely tickled and so happy that you have found somebody in your life that challenges you, a true soulmate. In the words of Dr. Evil, Jennifer, you complete him.
Oh, I'll never be lonely. You're my only one. And I love the things. I really love the things that you do. You're my best friend.
Mom, you've helped to make this day in all its splendor a reality. You've given me every chance in life, and you've always been there to support me through any of my endeavors, even if they put a few extra gray hairs on your head from time to time. Adam and I couldn't have had the wedding of our dreams without you, so from the bottom of our hearts, thank you so much. We are forever grateful for all that you do, and we love you very much.
To my mom, Linda, back over there, and to my dad, Herb, and his Jennifer here, I want to thank you so much for your constant love, support, and generosity. Growing up, you'd always remind us that this, you mentioned in your speech, that this was your first time around, and that we'd have to bear with you through your mistakes, we'll call them. 33 years later, you can take a look up here and over there and see the fruits of your labor, or mistakes, as you might call them. but as a result of your often much-needed guidance and hard work, you've managed to raise some healthy, well-rounded young men who can only hope to be as much of a positive influence on their children as you were and continue to be on us.
Under every fin, just another human pin.
It has been a true joy to watch Adam and Jennifer develop this loving, healthy, and supportive relationship, which they have now committed to in front of family and friends.
I promise to sing and play to you until we're old and gray, and even when my voice has grown tired and my hands can no longer play the strings the way they could before. I vow to lend you strength and support you as you chase your dreams, and to be right beside you every step of the way.
I wish you the happiness and the joy of family, and what wonderful parents and a couple I know the two of you will be. And like Caroline, I look so forward to a granddaughter. You can produce the boys, but I'm a-looking for the girl.
May you always love, live, and laugh. I love you both.
Nothing you would take, everything you take.
Perhaps it was the Italian muse, Lady Fortuna, who brought together our Cece and Mr. Big Tuna. So join me tonight in a rousing toast to celebrate a couple who deserves the best and the most. Congratulations. We love you.
Thank you.
night, eats you on the other side.